everyone else, Martin, Jake, and Cindy. Let's open it up to questions. I'll start. I'd like to see a show of hands. How many people here have used the book DTD? Wow. That's a lot more than I would have thought. How many of you are going to switch in the short term, do you think, to Bits? Awesome. More hands up a year from now, I hope. Okay, I think I saw a question somewhere in the middle. Right.
Yeah, hi there. This is Damien Hess from Avalon Consulting. This is really a question for the people who are going from Word to the NLM XML using Xtiles. How automated have you found that process to be? And second question, have you found any kind of best practices or guidelines to give to your authors to make sure that that transformation is as smooth as possible? And I even have a third question. Is the workflow pretty much one way? Are you going from Word to XML? Are you also going from Word from XML back to Word?
No. I'll answer your last question first. And right now, no, we are not going back to the source document to make changes, and that is not a best practice. As far as X styling goes, we have members of our staff who are more or less proficient with it. We have one editor in particular who's he's our go-to guy for more difficult projects. I have asked our editorial department in the past if we could go back and just not X style documents, would you prefer to return to the good old days? And their answer is inevitably no. And then they say, well, you know, X-Styles is a lot more work, but it's a lot more work up front that results in a cleaner document. So I guess that's a pro X-Styles pitch on my part. But your second question was, you might have to repeat your second question.
I might even remember it. One was with the how automated the conversion can be, and also if you have any best practices that you can give to your, or guidelines you can give to your authors to make sure that the word
right,
can
the authors,
actually get transformed.
I blocked that out. I had to zone out on that one. The guidelines that we provide our authors certainly precede our X-styling by a matter of, you know, 40 years or so. And we're still running into the same problems. And I think that, I think it's been touched on a couple of times here that authoring in the book world differs somewhat from authoring in the journals world. And book authors seem to have a lot more latitude in terms of what's an acceptable project. I think that it behooves us to, behooves my organization to give our editors a little more authority over certain aspects of the publishing process. And I think that that's, not to disparage my employer, but I think that's something we could definitely work on.
From our side, the conversion to XML from X-Styles is totally automatic in the sense that we don't do any tweaks to the XML on the back end for print. We do not produce Word files back from our XML. And as far as recommendations for authors, mine are a little more technical, but I would say if it's not a table, don't make it a table. But they'll make it a table. People try to do things in Word, not understanding what the ramifications are down the road. So, if you need something to be in a text box, please don't put it in a table. If it is a table, please don't do it with tabs. And if it's an equation, if at all possible, do it in a format that it can at least be converted to MathML down the road. So as close to math type as you can get it is ideal from in our workflow.
Yes.
I'm Chris Maloney again. excuse me. So I have a question about Bits is out in draft form, and I guess I'm kind of wondering how late in the game is it? How is it an alpha stage draft or beta stage? How much might it change? And especially after seeing Wendell's presentation, it seems like, it seems obvious that work should be done to harmonize bits and other resources that are already out in the community.
Jeff, do you want to, as chair of the working group, do you want to take that one?
Well, it's 0.2 now, so we have 8 points until we get to one. I know that's not a good answer. I think that we're going to have to see what the use is over the next few months and what kind of content we comments we get on the JATS list. I really don't know how. I can't say whether it's alpha or beta. I know that when the working group met in person just after or during the hurricane, we thought we had things nailed down pretty good. And we said, okay, well, we're going to put these things into an extension of JATS 1.0 when 1.0 becomes final. And so 1.0 became final, and I said, okay, let's make bits and roll it out the door in 2 weeks. And the working group said, wait a minute, we have some things to talk about. And we got together and we talked together in two or three conference calls and did some things over the email until we came up with this draft. So I'm sure there are still some things to work out, but I'm not sure when we're going to get to 1.0. Probably have to get to a point where we declare it and move on.
Yeah, I'm going to speak as a member of the working group, but sort of unofficially my own personal impressions. The first is we don't have any firm timeline. I think I'm safe saying that because we really want to work based on feedback. I mean, if we look back on the history of JATS, really the NLM DTD, we really didn't have a set timeline until we started to get to things like 2.2 and 2.3 because we began to see what the usage was. So I think part of it right now depends on what the usage and what the feedback is. I'm really going to stick my neck out with this next comment by saying that as a member of the working group, and this is more of a personal comment, I would tend to guide the working group towards keeping any updates between now and 1.0 to the greatest extent possible 100% backwards compatible with 0.2, so people who adopt it early aren't suddenly stuck because 1.0 isn't backwards compatible. I know even with JATS, we've had discussions at what points we feel comfortable breaking backwards compatibility. And I think that's important to encourage people to work with it. It is not, I don't think we've stated this explicitly, it is not backwards compatible with the current 3.0 book DTD. So you will have to make changes if you are used to using that. And Jeff, you've got your microphone on, so you look like you want to follow up on my comments.
Yeah, I think I want to agree with you that we're going to do everything we can to keep 1.0 or 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, whatever, backward compatible with 0.2, just for the reasons you said.
So the likely changes as we move forward in the draft would either be adding new elements or further greenification of what should already be a fairly green DTD. Tommy?
Something else to more directly address Chris's comment, which is commenting on the issues that Wendell raised. There is the possibility of dramatic change. The suggestion that this book's model would be more useful to the world if it was more DocBook-like or more DITA-like or more TEI-like than JATS-like is a really interesting suggestion, and something that perhaps the working group and the community might want to consider. But it does run contrary to one of the things that the working group flat out agreed on initially, which was that it was going to be as JATS-like as possible. And in particular, it was going to take minimal work to take a JATS journal article and turn it into a chapter in a book. And we wanted the minimal number of changes to that. And it is not possible to both write a tag set in which you can take an existing JATS journal article and make it a chapter in a book without having to do much, if any, work to it, and have a tag set in which you can take a TEI document and, poof, make it a chapter in a book, or a doc book document and make it a chapter in that same book. Not to mention, I'm not even sure what it means to take a DITA document or a DITA file set and turn it into a chapter in the book. And so I think although Wendell has raised a really interesting question, particularly with people saying, wait a minute, we don't want to make major changes, it's probably off the table at this time.
Yeah, I would like to take everything that Tommy just said and underline it. She just made a very, very important point, and I think it would be a big mistake if you took away from my presentation the thought that I think it would be a good idea for JATs or BITs to become TEI-like. That is not at all the idea here. On the contrary, I think the world is better served if JATs does what JATs does well and BITs does what BITs does well, while TEI is doing what TEI does well, right? And in respect to this, I think, you know, Chris used the term harmonization, which I think is actually really nice, because the point of a mapping exercise would not be to obliterate the distinctions or to make it so it didn't matter what you, which tags that you chose, right? I mean, if that's something that happens because it turns out that the differences between the two communities are only on the cultural level and have no ramifications at all on the technical side, then that would be fine. But I don't think that's very likely. I actually think that the cultural differences that go hand in hand with the technical differences, and what we need to do is the mapping exposes and under, you know, where you actually have benefits from choosing to be on one side of a boundary line versus another. So, you know, far be it from me to say that I mean, I'm actually going to go out there and say that it should not be TEI-like. And in fact, I think that one of the things, specifically to the point of scoping, and you know, the question about, for example, adding letter tagging into BITs, I think that would be a mistake. Personally, I think BITs is going to do much better if it tries to stay at a level much more you know, generic and not trying to address everything at the level of the element semantics in the same way as TEI tries to do, and uses other strategies that are actually well known within the markup community for modeling semantic data in other ways so that it can manage scoping without having to go through this, you know, periodic shedding of new element types that everybody has to adopt and learn how they work. That's not necessarily the best approach for BITs at all, even if it has worked very well for TEI. So what I'd like to see is a conversation about these things and exposing what these issues are, all in line with what Tommy has said, because I think BITs is going to do much better if BITs is, you know, finds its BITsness rather than tries to be something different.
Okay, great. Thank you. I suspect there are more questions out there, but I'm conscious of the fact that we've taken 5 minutes of the break, and we want to keep the 3:30 session on time. So thank you very much to all of the panelists. And if you do have questions, the panel will be here during the break if you want to come down. Thank you.